This is a quick video about mathematical modeling and using models to make predictions using data. First thing we need to talk about is a function, and it's a rule that takes an input, it transforms it, and produces a unique output. There can only be one value on the output for it to be a function. You can do this with a table, you can do this with a graph, or an equation. One of the things we need to point out is that if you look at the x-axis of this graph, it's time in seconds, and the y-axis is distance in feet. In mathematical terms, this is considered to be the range on the output side, so the distance is the range, and the domain is the input side. So input is on the bottom, and the output is on the right. You may also want to remember back in science, you learned about dry mix. So MIX means the manipulated or independent variable is on the x-axis. It's the first one in the data table, and the dependent variable is on the y-axis. So the domain is analogous to the independent variable. The range is analogous to the dependent variable. So hopefully that helps you understand that a little bit. If it's a linear function, it represents a constant rate of change between the quantities. We are looking at two specific things, this one thing versus another. And we've already talked about the independent variable versus the dependent variable. That's all this slide is talking about. So when you're looking at linear equations, you often begin with data and you collect that in tables and it's ordered. The data is then plotted on the graph, and I presume you know how to plot. You move over the value specified in x and up the specified value in y. So remember, the x-axis is always first in the data table, and it's what will go on the bottom. It's very unusual. I don't like this graph. It's unusual to have time on the y-axis. It's usually on the x-axis. When you are using graphs, you can, if it's a linear function, you can describe it with a formula using y equals mx plus b. Y is the displacement from the origin in the y direction. X is the displacement from the origin in the x direction. The m represents the slope, which is the rise divided by the run, so the change in y divided by the change in x. And b is the y-intercept, where this line crosses the y-axis. And then it talks about function notation. So here we have g as a function of t, and you can use any kind of letters that you need to in here. In this case, it's garbage production over time, or as a function of time. And in this case, the x-axis is our domain, and that's the number of years. And g is the rate of garbage produced in tons per day. And then you can see we have a y equals mx plus b equation here that describes the best fit line. So if the function notation is distance as a function of time, where the slope of 5 times the x value plus the y-intercept would tell you what the y value is. Okay, so d is a function of t, where t is time, slope is 5, y-intercept is 3. You can use this to make predictions. That's what that's showing. Coefficient of correlation tells you, it's called the R value. We use the sum. So if you, the closer to 1 or negative 1 it gets, the better the data is. If it's close to 0, it's not good. So anything that has a R value greater than 8 or greater than minus 8 is, or less than minus 8, I guess, is a strong correlation. Anything with a value of like 0.5 or negative 0.5 is a weak correlation. The one we use most often is the coefficient of determination, or the R square value. And what I want you to look at, it's one is a perfect. Think about it like a 100%. And so that means if you have an R square value of 65, it's like a 65% on a grade, which isn't really good. So it's telling you that it doesn't fit very well. The closer it gets to one, which would be like 100%, the better your best fit line or your trend line that you put on the data. To do this in Excel, you can use it to find trend lines. First of all, you have to put in A data table that has an x and a y, so your domain and your range, your independent and your dependent variables. So they have years versus sales. And then you insert a scatter plot to look at your graph. I would select the headings to get a little more information about the graph as you build it. I'm going to do a separate video for how to do this with Excel. Once you have that in Excel, you're going to choose add a best fit line, and then and tell it to include the equation and the R square value. And the equation will be in the y equals mx plus b format, and you can turn that into function notation by saying sales as a function of time is equal to the slope times the time in the domain here plus the y-intercept. And the rest of this is about using the formula and the graph to make predictions, and that's about that. I want to go back and look at this graph. So if you are predicting anything in this area here where you have data points, that's called interpolation, and it's very safe to predict inside this data. When you start going outside of that data, it's called extrapolation. And it gets to be really risky because you don't know if the data is going to continue this way for sure. It might suddenly decide that it needs to go down instead or up aggressively. So sometimes you want to be really careful about predicting outside of your known set. Just because you know what it was doing here does not mean you can tell me for sure what's happening here. All right, that's enough about graphs.